Good afternoon, friends. You are welcome to our tutorials today. Today we'll be discussing on anatomy and on the aspect known as the brachial plexus. In our previous video, we've talked about the root of brachial plexus. We talked about the trunk, the divisions, and the cords of brachial plexus. Today we'll be discussing about the branches of brachial plexus. The branches of brachial plexus can be grouped into two. One, the terminal branches. Secondly, the side branches. The terminal branches are the branches that arise at the ending aspect of the brachial plexus. The side branches arise from either the roots, the trunk, or the cords. It arises from the parts of brachial plexus. Now, there are five terminal branches. And you can remember these terminal branches using this mnemonic. My auntie raped my uncle. My auntie raped my uncle. My stands for musculocutaneous nerve. Musculocutaneous. When you say musculocutaneous nerve, from the word musculo, it supplies muscles. From the word cutaneous, it also supplies skin. Auntie stands for axillary nerve. Raped stands for radial nerve. My stands for median nerve. Uncle stands for ulnar nerve. So this is a simple mnemonic to help you remember the five terminal branches of brachial plexus. My auntie raped my uncle. Musculocutaneous nerve, axillary nerve, radial nerve, median nerve, and the ulnar nerve. Take notes, we have median nerve and we have medial cord. Both of them are quite different things. Now, let's now talk about the side branches of brachial plexus. Two side branches arises from the roots of brachial plexus. The first side branch we are going to talk about is called the dorsal scapular nerve. The dorsal scapular nerve arises from the roots of brachial plexus. Another name arising from the root of brachial plexus arises from C5, C6, and C7. We refer to this nerve as the long thoracic nerve. So you may be asked in exam condition, the long thoracic nerve arises from dash root of brachial plexus, C5, C6, and C7. Take note, all of these nerves give innervation to muscles of the upper limb. From this superior trunk of brachial plexus, two nerves arise. The first nerve is what we refer to as the suprascapular nerve. And the second nerve is referred to as the nerve to subclavius. Nerve to subclavius. So we're seeing two nerves arising from the roots, the dorsal scapular nerve and the long thoracic nerve. Two nerves arising from the trunk, the suprascapular nerve and the nerve to subclavius. Take note, only the superior trunk give rise to side branches. The middle trunk and the inferior trunk does not give rise to side branches. The division does not give rise to any side branch, but the cords do give rise to side branches. The lateral cord gives rise to a nerve called the lateral pectoral nerve. And it also gives rise to a branch here called the lateral roots of median nerve. So you can see the median nerve is formed from lateral roots and the medial roots. Both of them giving rise to the median nerve. Next, the posterior cord gives rise to five branches. And these include one, the upper sub scapula nerve. Secondly, the thoracodorsal nerve. Thirdly, axillary nerve. Fourthly, radial nerve. And lastly, lower subscapular nerve. You can remember the five branches from the posterior cord with the mnemonic STARS. S-T-A-R-S. S stands for upper subscapular nerve. T stands for thoracodorsal nerve. A stands for axillary nerve. R stands for radial nerve. And S stands for lower subscapular nerve. Of these five branches arising from the posterior cord, two of them are terminal branches. The axillary nerve and the radial nerve. They are the terminal branches. Upper subscapular nerve, lower subscapular nerve, thoracodorsal nerve are side branches. So you may be asking exam condition, list three side branches from posterior cord. Don't list axillary nerve, don't list radial nerve. They are terminal branches from the posterior cord. List upper subscapular, lower subscapula, and thoracodorsal. Next, we are going to the medial cord. The medial cord gives rise to five branches. One of them is a terminal branch, and four of them are side branches. So let's list them. All of them, to remember, all of them start with M, apart from the ulnar nerve. Let's go. First, we have the medial cutaneous nerve of the arm. Second, we have the medial cutaneous nerve of the forearm. Thirdly, we have the medial pectoral nerve. Remember the lateral pectoral nerve here? This one, the medial pectoral nerve. We also have what we refer to as the medial roots of medial nerve. Then we have what we refer to as the ulnar nerve. Five branches. One of them is terminal. So the medial nerve is formed by the lateral root of medial nerve and the medial root of medial nerve. Both of them combine to form the medial nerve. So given a preview of what we talked about, the nerves of brachial plexus, we've seen the terminal branches, which are musculocutaneous nerve, axillary nerve, radial nerve, medial nerve, and ulnar nerve. Mnemonic. My auntie raped my uncle. Side branches arising from the roots. Dorsal scapular nerve, long thoracic nerve. Side branches arising from the trunk. The suprascapular nerve and nerve to subclavius. No side branch arises from the what? The division. Side branches arising from the cords. Remember, for the medial cord, from the lateral cord, we have the lateral pectoral nerve and the lateral roots of medial nerve. For the posterior cord, we have the upper subscapula, thoracodosa, lower subscapula. They are the side branches arising from the posterior cord. Side branches arising from the medial cord, we have the medial cutaneous nerve of the arm, the medial cutaneous nerve of the forearm, we have the medial pectoral nerve, and we have the medial roots of medial nerve. One important point you have to remember, of these nerves we mentioned, the largest branch or the largest nerves found in brachial plexus is called the radial nerve. And the smallest nerve in brachial plexus is referred to as the medial cutaneous nerve of the arm. The medial cutaneous nerve of the arm. So these are the nerves that arises from the brachial plexus, both the terminal branches and the side branches. In our next video on brachial plexus, we are going to talk about these nerves and the muscles they supply. Remember, nerves innervate muscles. So the dorsal scapular nerve, the long thoracic nerve, which muscles do they innervate? Which muscles do they supply? That will form the basis of our next video. Thank you very much for watching this video, and please remember to subscribe. Thank you.